You may cleave to your courage, but that will fail you. Look to your weapons, but you will find them not enough. Run, fight, hide, pray, cry out or cower, it does not matter. For we are come.
The Executioners are a third founding successor chapter of the Imperial Fists. Proud scions of the 7th Legion, their patriarch Fafnir Ran would symbolize the vaunted legacy of valor, ruthlessness and honor of the captain's deeds. The headhunters of the Imperium, many of their peers looked to the chapter as little more than barbaric, ill-disciplined brutes. Yet beneath their gore-spattered exterior, the executioners harbor a concealed cunning and exploit their detractors' disdain for their demeanor. Among the most unwavering servants of the Imperium during its darkest days, the glory of the executioners speaks for itself and befits their stoic duty to protect the wider Imperium from threats among the Segmentum Pacificus. Based within the desolate void waste of the galactic southwest, the executioners have, regardless of their station, voyaged far and wide across the galaxy to mete out the Emperor's wrath. Claiming the planets of Stygia and Aquilin as their chapter worlds, the chapter monastery of Darkenvault rests within the armored asteroid base between the two worlds, revolving around the system's slowly dying star. Fighting alongside the Raven Guard, Space Wolves, and Angels of Absolution chapters during the invasion of Nova Sulis during 392.M36, for their vaunted service to the Imperium, the executioners would be honored with siring their own successor chapter with the completion of the campaign, the Iron Champions. As their renown continued to climb for millennia to follow, their fortress monastery of Darkenvault would be invaded by waves of orcs, xenos, tyranids, and demonic incursions, requiring the chapter in its entirety to rally to the defense of their homeworld. Already battle-scarred for their purge of an outbreak of enslavers at the borders of Imperial space, the executioners would be eroded to 300 battle brothers in number. Invaded by a worm-like xenos species of unknown origin, the executioners would send a distress signal to any nearby chapters to aid in their defense of their fortress monastery. Receiving the transmission, the Astral Claws chapter of Space Marines, aided by Battlefleet Tempestus, would add their might to the executioners as they began their final stand. Saving the chapter from extinction, the Astral Claws would receive a blood debt from the executioners to be redeemed whenever it would be needed of their saviors, stating that they would pledge their blades should ever the Astral Claws be threatened. Replenishing their numbers over the centuries to follow, their honor would regardless be besmirched during the conflict of the Badab War. Siding with the secessionists of the Astral Claws, led by Luft Huron, by virtue of their blood debt, the executioners would serve for many years at the side of the tyrant of Badab. Defecting to the loyalist cause of the war, as the veracity of their cause became false, with the conclusion of the Badab War, the chapter would be sentenced to a 100-year penitent crusade for their actions. Denied the right to replenish their losses with aspirants during their penitent crusade, the Salamanders would safeguard their chapter homeworlds in their absence. Their cultist purges made in the name of the Steel Unbound campaign of the Telamon Cloud would greatly aid their redemption in the eyes of the High Lords of Terror, leading to their war against the Pocket Empire of Chaos within the Galactic Core. Besting three Chaos Warbands and a traitor Titan Legion during their conflict, the chapter would earn vast glories for their actions, despite their circumstance. Destroying the secessionist enclave in the name of the Imperium, the executioners would lose several members of their first company veterans, yet claim an immense voidcraft, Achilles, as spoils of their campaign. Renaming the vessel, Sire of Mephusa, the executioners would, in their last recorded campaign of their penitent crusade, venture to the Orpheus sector. Finding the Necron Xenos to have decimated countless warriors of the Imperium prior to their arrival, the executioners would vow to accomplish their so-called death quest upon the war zones of the Orpheus sector. The chapter remains there to this day, serving out the final years of their penitent crusade, whether death or absolution shall be their reward. Strict adherence to the Codex Astartes, the executioners, despite their appearance, are a highly disciplined organization. Their proclivity for close quarters combat, one of the few deviations from their tome's outlines. Such shows of martial skill in the presence of their kin allows for the battle brothers of the chapter to prove their skill at arms. Ending disputes between battle brothers only through maiming and death, the honor of the chapter is beyond such reproach that each battle brother shall not tolerate attacks on their character lightly. Worshipping the Emperor as a god, though a pious chapter, the Sons of Fafnir Ran do not acknowledge the ecclesiarchy and its beliefs as more than a useful superstition to keep the subjects of the Imperium in line. Accruing slaughter tallies during each battle, holy feasts and memorial ceremonies are made within Darkenvault's catacombs to honor the rampages of fallen battle brothers, for the highest virtue of an executioner is the amount of enemies killed in the name of the Master of Mankind. Replacing the standard Codex-compliant Devastator squad with Stern Guard veterans, the chapter's bias towards attritional warfare littered with carnage belie their inheritance of their founder's temperament. Utilizing land speeders and heavy armor when possible, the chapter despises the use of assault bikes and hit-and-run tactics, preferring to entrench their forces into brutal assaults. Bellicose and barbaric in nature, the executioners show outright contempt for the trappings of more gaudy Astartes chapters. Carrying grim trophies of severed heads, claimed weapons, and other trinkets into battle, the show of a slain foe is enough to instill terror into the hearts of the enemies of the executioners. Using such trophies as proof of their slaughter tallies, such claimed spoils are discarded once verification of their kills are collated, unless proof of such a kill is of impressive enough pedigree to be preserved and adorn the Space Marine's armor. The metallic blue-tinted gunmetal gray of their panoplies of uniform design, the veterans of the chapter mark their pauldron and helmets with yellow paint to denote their rank. Battlefield specialty and squad identifiers adorn their knee plates, though the chapter does not utilize company markings on their armor. The chapter icon of the twin ebon axes on a red shield, honoring the deeds of their forebear, Fafnir Ran. This hallmark of the era of the Horus Heresy would adorn the shield of the Imperial Fist Legion, whom had served with distinction alongside the Seneschal of the Seventh. Harboring an unusually high number of chaplains within their ranks, three of such so-called Deathspeakers are assigned to each company of the chapter and report directly to their High Chaplain, known as the Lord Speaker of the Dead. Responsible for the precision record-keeping of each battle's victories, defeats, and actions, such devoted analysis of their battlefield data allows for their continual analysis and correction of flaws in their battle doctrine. Captains of the chapter are known as warlords and are accorded greater autonomy than their subordinates. Serving under their chapter master, the High Executioner, such warlords alongside the Lord Speaker of the Dead, Chief Librarian, and Master of the Forge, form the chapter's war council when planning their impending crusades and campaigns. Though the High Executioner bears seniority over any individual of the council, should a unanimous vote be set against the chapter master, the war council has the authority to overthrow and replace their High Executioner, should consensus of his failure to lead the chapter be evident. Contesting leadership of the Executioner's chapter is a bloody affair, as any company captain ambitious enough to earn the title of High Executioner can challenge the serving chapter master at any time to a contest of combat, should he wish to replace his superior. Believing their chapter to have been created for the sole task of slaughtering humanity's greatest enemies, the executioners care little for defensive engagements or deployments. Self-appointing themselves as the Emperor's Headsmen, each member of the chapter slays his foes with unrelenting fury in the hopes of perishing in battles worthy of legend. Their final act as a warrior recorded by their Deathspeakers to be chronicled as worthy executioners of the Emperor's will.